in 30 years, close to. And it's the one I was looking for, and I found it. And it was the original permit for our park services, which is just so cool. I was just like, whoa, God, you're so good, you know? And the things you find when you're searching for other things along the way, I mean, that's how I got saved. I was looking for something else, and I found Ephesians 4:30, don't grieve the Holy Spirit by the way that you live. And I was so convicted that I could hurt God in such a manner that it would be grieving him to him. And I gave my life to the Lord. Found that along the way. Pretty good. Well, along the way, looking for that permit, 30 years ago, I found some of my very first notes that I'd written basically to myself and then also to share with others about what God was doing in my heart with wanting to begin the ministry in the park. I talked, Conrad called today, and I was talking with him a little bit about some of it. Blows my mind. And I just thought how, you know what? I go, God has brought us so far. He's allowed me to tell the world, literally, with thousands of people from around the world that have come and visited at the park service. It's hard to imagine when you sit in a room like this with, you know, just a few people gathered together for Bible study. But literally, thousands of people from around the world, God has brought to allow me to tell them how good God is and how much Jesus loves them with all my heart. And those of you guys that know me know that's my heart. And then all of a sudden, it's like it hit me when I was handed my certificate of criminal certificate on Sunday after church. You know, I don't get a lot of certificates, okay? You know? I never went to Bible college. And so, but on Sunday, after the service, I was presented with a certificate of criminal arrest and something or other. You know, I know, you know, you thought my criminal days were past. Well, you know, I'm back. Well, all that to say, you know, I got this, you know, a citation, a criminal citation. It wasn't really a certificate. I'd like it to be a certificate, though, you know, but a citation. And so, and you know what? And I thought, you know, it's a citation because the enemy wants us to stop doing what we're doing in the park right now. And I wish I could think and find the words to that song that was there, because it talked about telling the whole world about his love. And I thought, that's where God's brought my heart. That's my desire. My wife would know anybody. I want to tell everybody that I possibly can about the love of God and Jesus. And we've got that opportunity. We've had it for years as God brought us to people, to us from around the world at the park. Kind of that backwards missions ministry like we've talked about many times. But at the same time, now he's given us a reach into the world, Hawaii with K-Lite Radio and Kalo TV, but now a reach into the world, you guys, into people's pockets on their phones with the Real Life Network. And it's all happening, and we're there, and I believe with all my heart that the enemy wants to stop it. And that's what he does. But you guys, we have unfailing love, stronger than mountains. And God reminds us, because he's placed us right on the edge of the ocean, that his love is deeper than the oceans. And it reaches to me. And God is good, man. He's good. You know, we have now, just for a quick note, for those that are watching maybe, or those that would have questions, yeah, I have no fears. I mean, they're not going to arrest me yet, you know, I don't think. And they're not going to they're not gonna shut the doors of Calvary Chapel, and so, but God is good, and just so you know, your pastor has hope, and not hope in anything, that any tricks I have up my sleeve or anything, but it's hope in God. God has been so good, you know, waking up on Monday morning after getting my certificate, you know. My citation, okay. I was just like, Lord, okay, all these people flooding my, praise God for friends and pastors and people flooding my phone with different places to look to see for help, besides just the Lord, of course, a given, but legal help and whatever. And where do you go? Where do you turn, you know? And it was just so cool how, Lord, you'll show me. And it was just neat how God just led through some friends of Kim's, actually, a girlfriend of hers that's a pastor's wife as well, to another friend just to give wisdom. And I got to sit and talk with this guy with just wisdom for a couple hours. And he's a great guy and encouragement. And so we can't fill you in on everything that's going on. We'll fill you on more later as things go. But really good. It's good stuff. And it's important because, you guys, right where we're at right now in the Word here, we're going to see that the dangers that lurk beyond for every single person's life are life and death dangers. There are blessings that are abundant in the Lord. We looked at it last week in chapter 28. Turn to Deuteronomy 28, leaving off where we left off last week. Deuteronomy 28 through 14, we studied in some detail, looking at the blessings for faithfully following and being obedient to the Lord. God had said that He'll set you on high, that He will bless you, and with blessings that will come upon you, and I love it, in verse 2, overtake you if you'll obey the voice of the Lord. It's like you're just faithfully obeying the voice of the Lord. You know, you're not even expecting it. You're just faithfully obeying the voice of the Lord. And next thing you know, you're overtaken by blessing. It's like God comes and He's already got a plan ahead of you. And He throws that blessing over you. And then the blessing for us again in that is not to be overtaken for obeying the voice of the Lord, but it's to be blessed in the city, blessed in the field. We'll see some of the other side of this as we get into the Word tonight. So, you know, outside, inside, wherever you're at, God can bless you. The city and the field, the fruit of your womb, the most important blessing of all, I think, for any parent, guaranteed that the fruit of your womb is your greatest blessing and your greatest hope and desires that go with it. And then there's your cattle and your herds and your flock, your basket and your kneading bowl. And then blessed will you be when you come in and when you go out, and blessed will you be all along the way, basically, in verse 6. When you come in, and blessed will you be when you go out. And then verse 7, listen, look here, we saw this. Just a quick important note. Though you'll be blessed when you come in and you go out, you will have enemies. Even though God's blessing you, you're going to have enemies. And it says, and the Lord will cause your enemies who rise against you to be defeated before you, that they shall come out against you one way and flee before you seven ways. You guys, important for us to understand and to note there that those blessings, and we talked about it a couple weeks ago,